Hello, Carlos. Good to speak with you again. If we can start with team news first, how are you shaping up going into tomorrow's game?
Okay, we know that tomorrow is going to be another tough and demanding game. Millwall is a team that is working. They are making a good season now so far. Then we know that they have a lot of strengths and we have to work very well to face this team because it's going to be, like I say, another demanding game, but something different of the other games that we have played during this year.
In terms of individual players, firstly, can I get a check on Jonathan Hogg? I know he was forced off midweek.
Yes, I think, like I say after the game, for me, is talk a lot about one player when the player is playing as a sick player and nobody realizes about this because it shows the character that the player have. And for me, this character helps to build teams because you need to have this mentality to be and to face championship. Then, fortunately, he recovered very well. He got some problems, but he suffered more the consequence of the problems in the night after the game. Yesterday, he started to feel well, and he training normal with the group, and he want to be one available player.
Aside from that, how is Danny Ward coming along in terms of his return?
We continue waiting for his recovery and for the moment that he came back with the group. We think that in the next international break, he can add to the normal training with the squad.
In terms of Alex Vallejo, hopefully I've pronounced that okay.
Yeah.
Is he now back and available after his period of quarantine?
He has 2 days more of quarantines, and after he finishes the quarantine, he will add to the squad. He is following a physical program during this day that the physical coach sent to him, and he is doing by himself in his home.
And final player for me on this front, Carlos, Tommy Elphick, who of course is returning from a long-term injury. Whereabouts is he at with his return?
He continued in the same process of the recovery. He had a long-term injury with the knee, and we are not expecting to have him in the squad because he continued managing his recovery with the medical staff. I know that he is a very good professional player. That's why he did the career that he has done. But we don't have him in the squad and we cannot be thinking of him because he's a long-term injury without to see the short term, he's not going to be with the squad.
Okay, thank you. In terms of Wednesday's game, now you've had a chance to reflect on the Birmingham defeat. What are your thoughts now, Carlos?
I think my thoughts are similar to the thoughts that I had after the game. Because I think when you have the 70% of the ball, it means that you dominate the game. But at the same time, both teams, we create some more chances of them, but they create some chances too, especially in the middle part of the first half. So what we need to manage is don't lose the ball, to don't give any option to them to counterattack. They play one team to trying to counterattack, trying to make some fall and use the set pieces a lot. And it was exactly the goal that they scored in the first half. So during the first half, I think during 50 minutes, we didn't manage enough well the ball. That's why we suffer counterattacks. But in the first minute, we managed well the ball without creating the chances that we want to create. So at the same time, for me as a team, we didn't create the chances that we should create in the first half. That's why maybe the position or maybe no, the understanding of some situation we couldn't solve well. Some situations that we solve better, for me, the options to increase the chances, or we will have more options to create chances. For me, the second half, the team did really well, because for me, the second half was exactly what we wanted to play. 45 minutes having the ball, 45 minutes dominating the game, 45 minutes always close to the opposite box, and creating the chances. And I think after we scored the goal, the spirit for us, like the feeling that we have, especially after the chance of Coroma, the team feel that they could go to win the 3 points. And sometimes it's not easy to manage these moments because at the same time, I think we need to go to the 3 points, but at the same time, without the option to lose the what we have achieved until that moment, and especially in the minute that we were playing. In this moment, we lost a little bit the position in attack and we were far to the positions to defense. And that's why after we lose the ball, they could have three players in the front of the attack. They create the chances. The chance go to the post. The second they won the second post. So we cannot we cannot think that everything is perfect, because if everything will be perfect, we will have won the game. So what we need to be thinking is in the details that we didn't do enough well. Because for me, this is how we can grow as a team. This is how we can prepare our minds for this, and our mentalities for the tough season, for one demanding season. So always we are going to watch the negative points to improve as a team, because I think it's how we can grow as a team.
In terms of that negative point that you mentioned, Carlos, when you are out of possession, how do you then use that as a learning experience to strengthen yourself defensively, strengthen your defensive structure moving forward?
I think in this game, the team wasn't in defense enough times. Like, all the moments in defense were transition moments. It means you are not organized, you lose the ball, and you need to react. In the moment that we lose our positions in attack, it means that we start to change a lot of spaces. We are going to be far of the spaces that after we have to defend. So for me, in this game, the key was more to control the position in attack, to come be closer to the position that we are going to defend. And for me, the goal that they scored was a clear example, because in the moment of the goal, in the action of the goal, we finished with a lot of players out of the positions. In this moment, we had Isaac dropping and Pipa Haya. We have O'Brien finish the action more as a winger. We have 18, instead to be closer to the central backs, he was far on the central backs. Pritchard, instead to be close to the opposite central back, he was close to our central backs. So we start to rotate a lot the position in our team. And this is the point that we should do better. Because for me, more than the defensive moment, the only defensive moment that was in this game was the defending of the set pieces. And it was how they score one action. We know that when you face teams with powerful in these type of situations, you are going to suffer. And what we try to create is the stronger structure that we can to suffer less. I think the team was doing really well after Rotterdam game, because for us it was an experience to improve the level of the team in the set pieces, reducing a lot or defending very well or defending better all the set pieces. What we need to do is to be thinking every time how we can adapt to defend better the situation that we know that the last year was one of the weakness points of the team. Mm. But right now, the team, I think, is working well. What we need to do is to watch the situation, analyze the situation, face the situation, and solve the situation. We cannot say that everything was perfect and forget about the things that we didn't do well. We didn't defend well one set piece, and it takes that we receive one goal. We didn't attack well in the last minute of the game, and we consider another goal. We cannot give the back to the players. We need to watch the players, to face them. This is the only way how we are going to be stronger.
Comparably then, Carlos, on that point, when you do have the ball in possession and you had high percentage statistics when it came to possession in that game, what do you need to do as a team to make that possession count, to break down the opposing side when you are on the edge of their area, to ultimately find the goal?
So first of all, we need to break the first line of pressing. I think in this game, Preston, for example, or Derby County, they put higher the first line of pressing and they try to difficult our playing out. But Birmingham was totally different. They went down with the first line of pressing and they were more compact in defensive half. So the first of all is break the first line that is going to press you. In this line can be higher or can be more back. And you have to break this line in one way or in another way, or you have one behaviors to do it when they are higher or one behaviors to do it when they are back, because it's different the spaces where they are, the distance in between lines, and the intention of the team in defense. Because usually when the team go higher to press you, the intention of the team is to provoke the recovery of the ball or force you to the mistake. When the teams weigh you, like Birmingham, they want to be compact, and the only thing that they don't want is that you break this line of press. They don't want to recover the ball. They are more focused to defending the spaces. So I think the key is to find behaviors to make both things, to come break this line. And the moment you break the first line of pressing, for me, start to appear the second moment. It's like, in which space you break this first line, and depending about where you break the line, which spaces you are going to find the advantage. Because in the moment you break the first line, if it's in the left side, they are going to make the balance to the left side. If it's on the right side, they will do the balance to the right side. Or if it's in the middle, they will be compact in the middle. And from there, the advantages are going to appear in one side or in another side. So for me, it's just understanding of the spaces, understanding of the possibilities that the player have. And when the teams are very complex, play very simple. This is for me one of the rules that we need to have as a team. Supporting a lot of the player with the ball because he's going to receive press. Try to play with not many touches and try to find the advantage depend that where they are.
As a coach right now then, Carlos, how or what kind of challenge is it to be able to communicate what you've told us there in what is now such a short space of time between games, Wednesday, Saturday, then either Tuesday or Wednesday again?
And again and again, it's like this will be the championship this year. So for me, the key that we have to have as a team is to have strong mindsets. It's like our minds have to be ready because it's more than the tactical moments, it's to be strong. It's like to continue having the confidence and to continue wanting to have the desire to grow as a player. And you only can grow as a player or as a team when you watch the problems directly, without an excuse, taking responsibilities. So for me, this competition is tough because you play consecutive, and that you play very consecutive, you need to have a strong mind to face any game. If you came from one defeat, you need to have a strong mind to forget the defeat, to learn from the defeat, but to strong to face the game, trusting a lot in yourself and trusting a lot in your team. So for me, there is two moments. The post-game moment to analyze what you have to do better to win the games, what you can do if you want to win the game, what you have to do to win the game. And at the same time, in the moment you know, add inside your experience, eyes inside yourself, and go and face the next game with a higher level of confidence. Because every game is very consecutive. If you are thinking and you continue having the feeling in the next game of the previous one, you can accumulate negative results easily because you don't have time to reflect and you don't have time enough to assimilate the consequence of the mistake, so of the negative result. So what we need to do is learn a lot and change fast the feeling, even when you draw, when you lose, or when you win. Because if you relax because you win, the next game is going to be the harder game, the hardest game. So what you need to do is, as fast as possible, reset your mind, learn from the back, watching the problems, taking responsibilities, and be more prepared for the next game.
A lot of those qualities that you've mentioned there contribute to an overall culture within the squad and the team. How important is it for you with your side to have a strong culture within the team?
I think it's the only important thing that we need to have. More than the style, more than the passes, for me, this is the most important thing.
How responsive have the players been then with you trying to instill that culture alongside the coaching staff behind you?
I think you cannot be a player, you don't have this mind. And you cannot make a career in England. You cannot have a career in Championship if you don't have this mind. So this mind is necessary. The players with experience are players that have this mind. And at the same time, the young players that we have a lot in the team, they have to take fast this behavior because it's something that you need to be in Championship.
How responsive have the players been to the learning as well? We spoke to Harry Toffolo this morning and he explained how not only are you doing a lot of team meetings at the moment, but you're doing a lot of one-to-ones with the players as well, individual meetings. How are the players receiving that information that you're giving to them?
We hope that they receive in the best way because sometimes we don't know a lot about football, but we try to work a lot trying to improve as a staff and improve the solution that we can give to the players. So what we do is analyze a lot all the details because we think that if we analyze, we are going to have better solutions, better answers as a staff and better answers as a players. So of course, when you are doing consecutive, you are going to analyze your team or you are going to analyze your performance three times or twice per week. And not everyone is like, you need to create the habit to do this, and the player need to feel comfortable watching themselves. So like you say, for me, this is part of the culture that we have here in Huddersfield. We like to analyze the game. We like to understand the game. We like to know what we are doing well, and we like to know what we have to do better, because for me, it's the only option that we have to grow. And of course, you're going to sacrifice our time, yes, because you are going to dedicate time, because sometimes the player could be with the family and they have to spend some time making in the concentration in the hotel. So in T2B, talking and freedom, they want to spend a lot of time with the squad, with the team, talking about the game, but at the same time, for me, this is our dream. Not only the dream of the staff, it's the dream of the players too. So I don't think that spending time watching football, I don't think it's something that the player doesn't like or don't like.
Yeah. One player I wanted to ask you about, Carlos, and we focus on the positives of Wednesday, was Isaac Mbenza, who of course scored that free kick. How pleased have you been with him so far this season? It's been a change of fortunes for a player who, of course, went out on loan last season. How pleased have you been with him?
I think as a player, we need to have, first of all, one continuity. Like, it's very difficult to get a positive performance from the player if we don't work regularly with the players. And sometimes we will receive from me the reward of the work that they are doing, maybe in a short time, maybe in a medium chance, or maybe in another time, or maybe never. We never know. But for me, the work with the player have to be a regular work with them. And not because now Isaac the other day scored, he has finished his growing process. The positive with Isaac is that he wants to continue, he has the ambition to continue grow as a player. He is 24 years old, so he's a young player with a lot of things that he can add to the team, and at the same time with a lot of things that he needs to improve as a player to continue growing. And this is exactly the mentality that I find in him when I arrived to the club. That's why I was thinking that he was ready to help. But at the same time, another player that are not getting the best performance, it doesn't mean that you are not going to get. What we want as a staff is to get the best performance in a short time. What our fans want us is to watch the performance of the players in a short time too. And sometimes the players want exactly the same, but sometimes easily they find a way, and sometimes they are a little bit lost, and they one day go and solve a good performance. Because I don't think we have any player that is not able in the squad to have a good performance for the team.
From what you've seen of him on the pitch and in training as well, Carlos, how far can Isaac Mbenza go? What is his potential, using your coaching experience to make your judgment?
I think Isaac is a player, first of all, he's an explosive player, he's one fast player. Always is important to have in the sides players who can win the backs of the defenders for the speed, for the timing, for the aggressiveness that they have going to the spaces. I think Isaac is a player that for me adapts better to play on the right side than on the left side of the pitch, even if he can play in the left side too, because he's a player that can, for me, is a player with a good cross, and it's something that he was working from we arrived here to the club. And at the same time, he's a good finisher, not only in the free kick like he saw the other day. For me, he's a player that can finish well the action in the front of the attack. I remember, for example, the action that he had versus Swansea. He finished very well one situation and was in the post and was very close to be goal. So for me, he can add to the team the movement in behind, he can add to the team the crossing from the right, and he can add to the team the movements to be in front of the keeper to make finishing. And what we want is to replicate the situation a lot of times in the game to can help him in the strength that he has. And at the same time, for me, the highest point of him is that he is winning the love of the team, and for me, all the fans too, with the hard working that he's doing. But this is something that is not only for Isaac Mbenza. For me, this is something that all the players have to do, because I think what our fans want to watch are players with the demanding, with the ambition to help the team, and with the effort to show that they have the desire to help this club.
Another player I wanted to ask you about, Carlos, was Juninho Bakuna. You brought him off at half-time on Wednesday. What, in your opinion, do you feel is the key to consistency with Juninho Bakuna's performances?
I think with every player, the key is the consistency. But at the same time, we are in one level where the player need to give you back a positive performance, because if not, at the end, the consistency has a limit. But this is not talking about the vacuna, this is talking about every player. Because if the process extends a lot in the time, there is going to be a limit where the player is going to be tired from the demanding of the staff, and the staff are going to be a little bit tired to repeat the same information and don't receive any result. So I think this is a process that the players need to manage. For me, consistency is key, and at the same time, the performance is the other key. So for me, you have to be like a one play that play in both sides, from the staff to the players and from the players to the team, not to the staff, from the staff to the players and from the players to their team. This is for me the way that they need to realize that has to be in this way.
Mm. And finally from me, Carlos, and thank you for your time. 8 games into the championship season, now you're placed 16th in the table. How do you reflect on your start to life in the championship?
Honestly, I don't want to be watching the position in the table, because the only thing that I want to be focused is what we didn't do well in the previous game, what we did well in the previous game, what we need to do in the next game, and what we need to, just this, what we need to do to have a good performance in the next game. So for me, our attention has to be this, have to be analyzing a lot our team, analyzing a lot the opponent, and mixing this information to prepare ourselves. So I think if you are watching the table, you are not focusing something that is going to help you to be in a higher position in the table. The only thing that can help us to be in a highest position, that of course, this is what every team in the championship wants, to be as high as they can be, is to be focused in the thing that are going to get this. And for me, the most important thing is the performance of the players. And the most important thing too is the mentality of the players. So instead to be focused in the position now in the table, we need to be focusing what we need to do better to have a better performances. And I hope that the better performances bring winnings. This something happens and something doesn't happen. When it doesn't happen, we don't have to be thinking that it was by coincidence. We need to be thinking that there is a reason in the back what is telling us that we need to do something better.
Good luck for tomorrow, Carlos. Thanks for chatting. Thank you.
Thanks, Jenny. Anything to add, Ricky, finally?
Yeah, hi, Carlos.
Hello.
I just wanted to ask you about Harry Toffolo. We spoke to him earlier this morning. He's going to play tomorrow, if picked, 100 consecutive games for Huddersfield and Lincoln. And he also spoke about how he now feels, he goes into games and he knows he's going to be fitter than who he's taking on, so the opposition player. You know, in terms of fitness, how nice is that to hear from a perspective?
I think like everything have a lot of links or relation with other things. I think the Harry Toffolo, if he plays tomorrow, is going to show, but even if he doesn't play tomorrow, playing 99 consecutive games, I think is a lot for, it like talks about the mentality that he has as a player. You cannot play consecutive games without a stop if you don't have the right mentality. It's impossible. And I think the right mentality helps you to develop yourself as a player, to develop your tactical levels, to develop your technical levels, and to develop your physical levels. For me, it's the demanding that he has with himself, what allows him to be in the level that he is, and what allows him to come play consecutive or games in a row.
Just wanted to ask you about Fraser Campbell as well. Obviously, he's technically your only recognised centre-forward. He started the last 3 games. Is there any, you know, possibility that you might rest him, obviously, to keep him fresh, obviously, playing Saturday, Tuesday?
I think this is a situation that we need to manage with all the players. Like you say, like, unfortunately, we don't have Danny Ward. Fraser Campbell is the only striker that we have now in the squad. And to play concept games in a row, you need to manage this. Because at the same time, Fraser Campbell is one player that when he goes to the pitch, he's going to give everything that he has inside himself. That's why he did the career that he did. And that's why he continued playing football like he is 20 years old, even be more than 20 years old. So the key for me is to be managing these moments can help us to be fresh for the game. But sometimes the players need to continue playing to be in better condition, because sometimes it's the habit to play what allow you to continue playing. And for another player, it's total opposite. They need to rest. For another player, every player is going to be different. So for the fitness levels of the players, sometimes play help you to play. And for another players, rest help you to play. So depend about the player, you can give more minutes or manage better the minutes.
Yep. Just wanted to ask about Nabi Sarr as well. So he's back into contention tomorrow, is that right?
Yes, tomorrow he's going to be available and tomorrow he come back to the team.
Yeah, good stuff. And finally, just on Alex Vallejo, I know you said that he's out of quarantine after two more days. Would that make him available before the international break, or would you expect him to be back in after the international break?
First of all, we want to see the needs of the team, because like I say, you, for me, Hawk is the only player without a clear replacement. You can play with Aiden in this position, you can play with O'Brien in this position, you can play with one of the central backs in this position too. But that's why we bring Alex to the squad and to the team. But I think I don't expect that he be ready in a short term, because the player was long time without play, and after the quarantine, you never can work in the same possibilities that when you are not in quarantine moment. So I know that he is very professional player. I know that he was preparing himself a lot before he arrived here, when he in the lockdown before to this summer, he was preparing and working a lot, but at the same time, never is the same to work by yourself than to work with the team.